The Minister of State for Finance, Henry Musasizi, appeared before the Parliamentary Committee of National Economy to justify a request by government to borrow $325 million, approximately 1.239 trillion, from the Islamic Development Bank and OPEC Fund for International Development to upgrade national roads. Musasizi lined up three projects to benefit from this loan, including upgrading of Katine Ochere Road, which is 70 kilometers, upgrading of Chenjojo, Bwizi, Ramwanja, Kahunge, which is 68 kilometers, and Impara Bwizi, which is 37 kilometers. Another project is the construction of Masindi Port Bridge.
In Parliament, as soon as Parliament approves for us, we will be able to finalize the agreement and then start the project.
However, there was resistance from the committee as the minister lacked the critically required documents to back up the loan request, especially the president's letter that clears the borrowing.
The fact that every other loan we are getting, one, they are missing requirements. Two, even when they appear with a few requirements before us, they are not certain of what they are handing over to us. I think, Chair, that demonstrates that the ministry comes and presents a loan before a parliament when in the real sense the ministry is not ready.
We need a letter from the president, because previously the president has accused our committee, and we want to be very clear now that one time we met the president in the last parliament and we agreed that every borrowing that comes to parliament, there must be a letter from the president. So we don't have a letter from the president yet.
The confusion escalated after members of parliament discovered that part of the loan to be borrowed from the OPEC Fund for International Development expired in June 2023. The committee vice chairperson, Robert Migade, landed on documents indicating that OPEC approved the loan offer of $30 million for Uganda in June 2022, and it expired after 1 year.
What you did was just to block off the page for expiry. What I mean is that they just plucked off the page for expiry. And so the creditor wants is there a new agreement?
Minister Musasizi labored to explain that the loan request is still valid, although he could not provide proof of renegotiation after expiry of the initial agreement.
This arrangement had expired. Why would I be here? Why can I present something which has expired?
So just tell us. We just need information. If it has been revisited.
The committee asked the minister to avail documents confirming the validity of the loan request if the committee is to proceed with the matter.
So only that what we may need from the ministry is to prove to us that this loan is not expired.
The committee also questioned how projects under this loan will be implemented when the future of UNRWA is being threatened by the proposed rationalization of government agencies.
Now we are borrowing money to give it to Minister of Works that has no capacity. Have you seen the minister here? He can't appear here. The minister is interested in having UNRWA under his docket. That's all.
Pass the loan or you don't tell us and we don't pass the loan. Unless you are interested in not serving UNRWA. Some of us are interested in serving UNRWA.
That's why. The $30 million loan from OPEC Fund has a period of 20 years with a grace period of 5 years at an interest rate of 2% per year. Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.